Hello everyone, my name is Andre Hodge and I go by the name of Servant of Truth, and I have a website, servantoftruth.org, and I've got my own YouTube channel, and I've been making videos for Andrew for the last 6 months or so as well, relative to his classic collars and many other themes that we've sort of covered. And I was just having a chat today on Tuesday the 9th of May 2017 my time, which is the Monday night, the 8th of May for Andrew at this moment. And we were just having a general conversation, and something very interesting sort of happened. And it's in relation to the Schumann frequency resonance of the Earth and its effect on us. And it actually like had a bit of an impact on Andrew, and it's quite a unique scenario at the moment, but it's a potential that sort of may be increasing going forward, and it's had some instances in the past that we sort of might reflect on. So what I felt I wanted to do with Andrew is just do a quick update, because I actually know a few people around the place that have actually been affected by it, and what we want to do is just offer it as a frame of reference for what you may have experienced over the last couple of weeks and this recent sort of few days, with a bit of information and context with Andrew. What I want to do here is just do a quick recording and offer it as a reference so we can go forward and offer it as that for you to reflect how you've actually individually been this last couple of weeks. So Andrew, first of all, we'll just do some basic sort of offerings of what the Schumann resonance is. Do you want to actually offer it?
Sure. So there are a variety of ways to explain the Schumann resonance. The easiest definition for those that are not scientific is everything that is space has a magnetic pulse around it. And our Earth is creating a magnetic pulse. That pulse is omnidirectional, pulsing in and out. And that pulse is the Schumann resonance. It goes to the edge of our stratosphere, and then that pulse comes back in, goes out and in, constantly in a breathing process, in a toroidal breathing process. That is essentially the Schumann resonance, the background electromagnetic frequency of how particles follow North Pole to South Pole and what flow the particles go in. So the graph here that we're showing on the 6th of May began a series of spikes in the Schumann resonance. And you can see in the graph how high they're going. Now, if you were to have a longer term of this graph and go over the period of years, none of this stuff would be this high. And on the graph on the 8th, you can see it's jumping over even the 110 series. What that is meaning is the way electrons from the North Pole to the South Pole are being exchanged at the stratosphere means it is going very fast. That means the inside of our Earth, the inner Earth, which is creating the most amount of coalition of electromagnetic particles, is going through the crown of the Earth and coming out the base and making the magnetosphere that goes around Earth. That magnetosphere is taking particles in from our solar system. And some of those are highly charged gamma particles, magnetic particles, light wave particles. All of this is charging up the dynamo that is the magnetic Earth process. So that is the Schumann resonance. We as individual beings who are made up of 67 trillion plus cells, who use water and pH as electrical conductivity, and we use chemical stimulus electron conductivity, meaning we do have a pole, positives and negatives within us, our consciousness can tune in to the Schumann resonance, or the heartbeat of the Earth, the way in which Earth can commune or communicate to those on its surface through this background electromagnetic frequency. And it is your consciousness inside your body, and the body becomes the instrument of understanding the Schumann resonance.
Very cool. Yeah, I was sitting here listening, mate. It's pretty interesting in real time. So
some of the things that have been affecting me, lack of sleep. Well, this is for me, someone that is very sensitized to these changes. Now, in previous iterations, I would speak about consciousness earthquakes or consciousness spikes that were going on. This is when humanity as a whole was creating its own pulse of electromagnetic frequency, which was trying to indicate to the Earth Schumann residents its level of readiness to communicate. So think of it like echolocation through these electromagnetic spikes. So like a whale, I can go, but I'm doing that in my auric field, sorry, with the crappy whale impersonation. But it's the metaphor. I can create that pulsing energy within my own auric field. That is my communication back through the medium of the Schumann resonance to the consciousness of this planet. Or collective consciousness of this planet.
Maybe here, mate, I'll offer, like, you asked me my perception of what the Schumann resonance is, and it can be like a, like, you call me C-3PO, the universal translator droid, right? So, like, my attitude when Andrew asked me prior to this recording what it was and what it felt to me is that, to me as an individual, what I felt was when I entered sort of meditative states, or maybe you can actually offer some detail after this, Andrew, about the brainwave patterns like alpha, delta, theta, and beta states. When I actually entered a particular state, I felt I was, as an individual, in harmony with, say, the Earth and the Schumann resonance, and there was this threading of the needle and alignment. And then what happened was, like you mentioned, the heartbeat of the Earth Mother, it felt like I was in harmony with all that as an expression on the surface. And and I would go into these states, and I know, say, from doing grid work and going to sacred sites and all that, it's a very nourishing state, and a very, like, it's like the infinite. I see it like the nourishing is on that level where you can sustain yourself, and the perceptions kick in. And to me, I actually offer it. It's like Andrew's offered, say, the sacred neutral perspective. When you're in that sort of state, then the Akashic is sort of available.
Easily. So another frame of reference, think of a plumbing system that has a pressure in it to keep the water flowing. The Schumann resonance represents the overall pressure of how fast energy moves through the ley lines of this planet, through the micro and macro versions of the ley lines, how they affect communities and consciousness, and then sub-communities and consciousness. You know, there's, for every layer, there's another layer right over it. And this is the other thing that the Schumann resonance represents, how multiple timelines can become singular timelines. And that linear time is a single bar on the graph of the Schumann resonance, but there's an infinite amount of graphs that can be bars that can be added to this, the sub-channels within frequencies. And those are alternate timelines that when we go through these bursts of Schumann resonance, there are timelines that are technologically created that become unstable very fast, for the consciousness that is on it is suddenly realizing, hey, there's other consciousnesses of myself around. They may not know what's going on. Sacred spaces and places, like we were talking before in grid work, you know, that is the plumbers coming to the plumbing sources, the wellsprings, and making sure the flow is going good.
So, like, we've got the graph up, and, like, at the moment of this recording, we haven't created the video, but the offering will be there so you can actually see it. And the spike is, like, what you said is there's pretty much nothing been like this in recent times, Andrew. Is that what you're sort of suggesting?
Yeah, and I was speaking about this as much as 3 years ago, that the Schumann resonance would go into high spikes. And that is when the opportunity for global dream time would happen. That is when people will have been multiple forms of deja vu, micro-mystical experiences to macro-mystical experiences, you know, all in linear time at the same time they're doing their job. Mm-hmm. And they'll have to determine in their own process what's going on. It's like tuning into multiple AM frequencies at once, you know, just a slight turn on the knob and you're 1/10 of a degree off and you're hearing another station in Cincinnati versus the station in New York.
I'm sort of getting now, like you mentioned, like some summaries of what this might be. So I've got some references to speak to you about. But you mentioned like the feeling and sensation might be like a spiritual seasickness. And, I can feel with that, like, there's this uncomfortable and uncertainty and many, many themes relative to it. But the key is, like, that uncomfort isn't something to avoid. It's probably to go in and explore and what is on the other side of it. Do you want to actually, because I feel like there's a lot of people actually being affected by this, mate.
Yes.
And they've got no reference for it.
Yeah, thank you for using that seasickness reference. So have you ever been seasick or airsick?
I've had conversations with Andrew about going on playgrounds when I was young. And I used to go on these, like, spinning things, and I got, like, I would, like, be violently ill, like, from
get violently giddy, ill.
From being giddy, basically. Giddy, that's what, yeah.
Or you lose your point of reference, and you go into some form of vertigo or crossigo.
Absolutely.
So in this form of seasickness, your consciousness expands and contracts in one tick of the second. And so imagine yourself on your way to work, and all of a sudden you're thinking about stuff that has nothing to do with your life in any way, shape, or form. And it seems absolutely normal, and then you come to a stoplight and it's over.
Mm.
Okay? Or when I mean stuff that's like literally you're experiencing somebody else's life or some alternate version of your own life that doesn't make sense.
Mm.
These are those other timelines bleeding through.
Mm.
This Schumann resonance, the spike in it, it ultimately determines those that are on the separation of density timeline, those that are saying I'm a sovereign enough being to stay a transforming being of light, meaning light that's coming to me, I am transforming it into a higher form of light around me, making sure my own Schumann resonance is increasing, my own density of light is increasing in my environment, saturating in it because your bubble of reality means something to you. When we have spikes in the Schumann resonance, that means there's a tremendous amount of energy available for people to do shamanic things, magical type things, and actually able to mine like the miners deep underground, pulling out the high powered energies to make mystical moments that are long lasting affecting to you. So one of my own personal experiences on the first set of spikes on the 6th, here where I live, we've had this bout of rain that has been going and 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 going. So we had like 3 weeks where we only had, you know, 1 or 2 days of actual sunshine. And on the 6th, we had almost a full day of sun. And I put my work aside and I just went out there and I put my feet up in the sun and I fell asleep. And I ended up having like, I don't know, like 200 dreams in a span of an hour. And when I woke up out of that, I was in that deep, you know, you can't move your body or anything. But I realized I was still in the sun. And as soon as I got through that jello of awareness, meaning I was just in that hyper expression of many dreams, it was as if I could walk in the dream itself. And I could feel the pulsing of the sun. And my own personal consciousness, I allowed it to go through the jelly and get to the edge of our stratosphere and realize the energy waves that are coming in through our sun have really activated Earth herself to be in, let's just say, much more form of communication to us. So think of it like a friend that's, you know, a next door neighbor that's always there, always interacting with you. And then there's a flurry of, hey, I'm having a reunion, or hey, I'm having a party. I need you to come help me. Things that are new forms of connection, but at the same time, you're used to it. I mean, it's natural to find yourself to be in service to the energies of the earth.
Yeah, like maybe you're drawn to go out to nature and just like disconnect and breathe and like walk barefoot on the earth and or go to the beach or something like that. Yeah, like I can sort of see, Andrew, like you mentioned about you know, the dense space and the light space of Earth and the solar system going through. Is there, like you mentioned the sun also, like is there a relationship between the sun specifically or like the galaxy?
Our solar system has its own Schumann resonance. And our Earth is floating in the Schumann resonance of our solar system. And we as human beings are in both Schumann resonance, in the bubble of Earth space, but also in the Earth that is in the bubble of the Schumann resonance of our solar system. So there's two layers to see this here. So the Earth Schumann residence, if you look on the 8th of May, has gone well over the 110 rate. That's unheard of. This doesn't happen. And it's still increasing. So we have entered a section of solar space where the solar density magnetic frequencies are so fast moving that the planets themselves are now cycling up their magnetic frequencies. And all the beings that are on the surface, subsurface, and astral must also begin that process of operating as their electrons move faster to north and south pole processes. And it'll be our consciousness that entrains our personal magnetic field to be in communion with the changes on this planet as well as the solar system. Yourself and your higher consciousness. We all have know our higher self. A higher self is what tunes into the solar system Schumann resonance and allows that medium of our consciousness to connect to the instrument of our bodies.
So I've got two things to sort of align with this, because what we want to do is actually, Andrew's here in no time and he can perceive all the audience individually and as a frequency, as a total. And to me, mate, it feels like there's two truths about this potential, because what we're doing here is actually offering it as a reference for future experiences of this stuff. Mm-hmm. And people can offer, like, reflect on themselves for the last couple of weeks and this particular weekend of how they've rode it in themselves, good or bad. And to me, there's two things, mate. There's one, this is probably going to trigger a lot, like you're saying, the instincts will kick in, or maybe I don't want to use the word activations, but that maybe there's contracts that people are here for and they're being triggered with this in the harmony of the universe. And then there's the other thing is the truth of where an individual is at, and maybe the unresolved is right in their face, you know? So it's amped up on all scales, you know what I mean? Is that something that's in alignment with this at the moment?
Yes, everything is amped up. On the human Earth scale, and on the solar system scale. So think of us human beings as the microvolts, the planet the macrovolts, and then the planet is the microvolts inside the solar system Schumann resonance. So that goes up another scale. And then our solar system has the part of the galactic Schumann resonance, which is the background electromagnetic frequencies of how light is exchanged in the propagated medium.
So good, like, a lot of people have their talents revealed by this stuff, and they might get a glimpse of it, and then they go back to a normal, or it could be a sustained sort of thing.
Well, it all depends on the nature of the person. So if the person's naturally a consciousness explorer, they will tend to have more of those types of frequencies, some more of those types of experience. Remember, the Schumann is a resonance. Mm. So it's trying to match what you're going through in equal co-creation. So if your focus is on politics, that stuff will be greatly amplified for you. If your focus is on spirit, that will be greatly amplified. And it'll be your consciousness going through the ups and downs of all the energy trying to transform light into an experience that has memories. So let's say we could choose a sleeper, you know, a person that's got a 9-to-5 job. They got to go to work. They got to get some of them. They get caught in morning traffic, so it's their morning traffic where they're going to engage some of their theta processes, meaning they're in deep consciousness and still able to drive and focus, and really able to get into the depths of their minds. That is when the Schumann resonance will greatly affect those types of sleeper personalities, whenever they are naturally in their deep contemplative processes, because whatever it is, the slave job still has that stuff to it. It's how people keep themselves normal. Mm. Now, if it's a spirit person, they go to do their morning meditation on a cyclical process and the Schumann resonance is way up, they may begin to have very intensified experiences or very dull experiences. Now, the reason I say dull is because they're used to a certain level of experience, and when the Schumann resonance is so high, they're not operating with the fullness of their frequency, and they might get the urge to go out. They might have other things frantically happen in their system to block them from raising their frequency equal to the background of the Earth, instead of it being the usual 3.5 that it's been for the last, you know, few years. Yes. And if it's all of a sudden it's way up high, you've got to take the time to raise your frequency.
Mm-hmm. Thought patterns and chaos and all those sort of things, and willingness to observe yourself and pull yourself back and go, whoa, you know, like let's keep it a bit simple for a bit. So
and all the electrons are moving fast. That also means our unseen world is moving even faster. So that means the entities, non-physical entities of this world, you know, think of it, you know, they're charged up. I don't want to call it, you know, drugs, but they're really amped up. They've had quite a few cups of coffee.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to call it, you know, cocaine or anything like that, but quite a few cups of coffee, and they're not going to stop. Mm-hmm. And what are they doing? What they normally do, just at a faster pace. So people might find drama suddenly appears and disappears, long moments of intense, oh my God, what's going on in my life, followed by mystical experiences, followed by boredom.
Yeah. Like
your patterns be accelerated.
Yes.
And if you notice your own accelerated pattern system within this consciousness spike.
There's another thing I can sort of offer here, mate, because I've talked about this a lot individually to a lot of people. And I've never asked you about it, and it's probably a good point to ask, is that, and I'm making a lot of assumptions with your audience, but I know a lot of them are pretty incredible beings that find your stuff. And there's a lot of powerful beings out there that don't recognize their impact on others. And what can happen is, if you are, by your innate nature, who you are, and you're a conscious explorer, and you do the healing and the self-nurturing and the revocations and all that, the thing is, you being around others is probably going to amp their worst up, and you get projected all their crap. Is that something that's, you know what
yes,
I mean?
Yes, yes, yes. That's all processes are accelerated. All patterns are accelerated. So there's the inevitable where when the frequency spikes are so high like they are now, those that cannot raise their frequency become their programs accelerated. So what would take somebody, a normal person, you know, weeks to get angry over something will be in moments. Because they're being driven to release the energy, because consciously they can't, but subconsciously it's going to happen anyways, because the electrons are moving so fast.
Yeah, so the separation of densities is removing the components of density in the individual, no matter where they are on the consciousness exploring path. And
right.
You as a ant dart healer and facilitator for the removing of this, it might feel like people going nuts around you. They're projecting you. And there's this constant theme in humanity of defeat the healer, not facing their stuff. So you as a powerful being, amped up, going around people that aren't wanting to face their stuff, might get an exponential projection of their unresolved, you know.
It's a good way, an exponential projection of their unresolved. Seriously, scientifically well put.
but I mean, like, I speak to Andrew, and I've had many chats to a lot of people, and I interact with some pretty powerful beings around the world, and they don't realize this in themselves. So maybe we're just using this as a reference for those sort of themes. Like, if you're a master of yourself, then there's a potential byproduct of this going on around you. I mean, that just gave me an opportunity to ask Andrew about this and offer it in this process here.
So the cool thing about this Schumann resonance spike, you know, if you guys are looking at the graph there, eventually it's going to come down. Now, that is where things are going to get strange. So those that have never experienced high Schumann resonance before, well, you have in previous lifetimes, but the last time there was a massive shift was in the harmonic convergence in, I think, 86, where it spiked for a short period of time and then came back down. Now, those that are conscious explorers engage the Schumann resonance and raise their frequency to match the new level, create self-healing and nurturing moments in those expressions of high Schumann resonance time. When the consciousness spike comes down is where your greatest healings will begin. Rewiring, recircuiting, your guides and guardians coming and doing mass energy clearing and healings on you. So that the next spike that comes, you will be more prepared to deal with the different form of self-healing and nurturing and the communication that it takes. Conversely, those that were just the programs at full speed because they consciously could not entangle, they still had the spike happen to them, but it didn't create separation of densities. It's like the car engine that didn't turn over. No. The battery didn't have enough charge, or the consciousness didn't have enough charge to let go of its polarity. Now, when magnets are in alignment, all of their the way their electrons are all flowing create an aura around it, or the toroidal field. Now, those that were in unawareness, when the Schumann resonance goes down, their auric field is going to be very confusing to them. It's going to be giant one moment and small another moment. Giant one moment, small another moment. So like, if you're used to 100-degree weather, you know, for months and months in a row, and then the next day it's, you know, 15 degrees outside, what kind of shock is it to the system? So the unawareness will be going through energy shock. They won't know why their aura is expanding and contracting, and many of them don't even know they have auras. But that mass expansion and contraction will just draw up paranoidal type stuff. Why? Because they don't know where it's coming from. It's an unknown to them. And they will reach out to us who have some form of knowingness. We're not afraid of it. We don't know what it is fully, but we're not afraid of it. We're going to engage it in our own way. We're not going to engage it with fear. They will be intrinsically drawn to us. Yes. Why? Because we get it.
Yes.
And that's where what you were saying before, many of us will be the target of projections in unawareness.
Yeah.
The key for us on the other side is infinite forgiveness, infinite love without strings, attacks, and attached and or covert motives behind it.
Yeah. Like my attitude, I mentioned the theme I sort of operate in is threading the needle. So, like, to me, if I can master my, like, meditation and my brainwave states, which I don't mechanically operate in, I just feel it's a very nourishing state to be, and I'm in harmony with the earth and stuff, then I'll be doing what's right for me and it will just work out. You know, I keep it simple in me, and it's like I just feel everything's in the flow with me. So all this stuff is around us. So we're sort of giving a frame of reference of what is a possibility, and maybe in the past these sort of events have happened and then you get bogged down in the issues around you, but you can also like just flow in it. And to me, mate, it feels like this is a great ally to us, even though it might not feel comfortable. It's a massive ally.
It is the heartbeat of our planet, and when we can become entrained using the law of entrainment with the heartbeat of the planet, we have access to unlimited sources of energy to use our precognitive workforce inside us.
Mm-hmm.
And break those words down, precognitive workforce inside us.
Yeah, like randomness and synchronicity in alignment with the earth will be amped up as well. You know what I mean? Like the benefits and potentials are there. It's like for me, like I said, if I master my state, then those things are there to be met, you know. It's just waiting.
Okay. So I want to add another thing of a type of experience that people may begin to observe in others. So a lot of the audience is, you know, they have friends that they want to wake up, and they ultimately know that they're not going to until they do, but they keep trying until the point they're enabling. Okay, those people that are enablers meaning, you know, you're always forwarding emails about this and that, look at this and this, you are going to get hit the most when these consciousness spikes go up. The spikes in the Schumann resonance go up, and then their consciousness is forced to go up. So my advice to those information brokers and sharers, you know, who are like, you know, telemarketers, constantly bringing the next thing up for the next person to be awaken. Stop doing it is my advice to you. The amount of energy that you're going to lose, disappointment that you're going to get, versus going out into nature itself and using the words Andre and I have described here to create your own membrane of connection, the body being the instrument for the mystical experience to flow through you, of the rapid flow of energy that's happening during these great spikes in the Schumann resonance.
Yeah, like my attitude today, it's Tuesday the 9th of May 2017, and my attitude was, my instincts were like, the sky is blue where I live, like the birds are tweeting, I feel like going to my city, Adelaide, Australia's botanic gardens, and just go walking around the trees and stuff and breathing the air and maybe listen to some meditation music and just chilling out, you know, like disconnect. I'm here with Andrew now because we've had this interesting chat, but that was my instinct. It's something I do now and again, just to go into a meditative state and just like be around nature and stuff. And I feel like I'm in Adelaide for a very special reason. I walk the streets and stuff like that. I don't really disconnect like that, but that was my instinct, mate.
So these Schumann resonance have been going on since April. But this is the highest spike that we've now had. So just before Easter, the standard Easter is when these Schumann resonance spikes begin. Mm. Now, the next layer is when we have a massive Schumann resonance spike and a full-on solar flare particle process hit our planet. Mm. And not it's not going to be a kill shot or anything like that. We have solar flares that send you know particles to us all the time. So if we have a big X class or a double X class solar flare combined with a high Schumann resonance, I think that is a prime opportunity for those that are consciousness explorers to have one hell of an experience if they really make it sacred, do the proper work, connect to the heart, and
have a salt bath,
contract, you know? Salt bath, contract revocations, do whatever it is that they do to protect themselves, which is your out loud name it to claim it system, meaning these are my boundaries and I'm enforcing them with my energy. That is what the contract revocations are meant to be. It's you saying I'm in residence with my own bubble of reality, which is in common residence with this planet, or Schumann residence.
Yeah, I've got this attitude, mate, and I hate to trigger the Patriot programming at all in other people and stuff, but I see myself as like a SAS, you know, special forces military soldier on the consciousness level. Like, I master myself and I take total responsibility for myself, and I'm not really responsible for anyone else's journey. And that's part of the threading the needle in me. Like, I operate in that way. I see the validness in that self-mastery of being the best I can be amongst it all. And doing all those things, like, I do salt baths and foot salt baths. You mention them all the time. You know, the revocations. I've even got like another affirmation book that I read as well in parallel to yours and stuff, you know. So interesting.
Yeah, so people, pay attention to the common Schumann resonance, pay attention to the solar flares, and when you see that they are becoming an alignment or just the Schumann resonance is going up, get out there and do your practice.
Use it as an ally.
Carve your time out of time to have your no time experiences.
Very cool. Is there anything else you want to add to the frequency of this recording, mate?
Yeah, it's your window of opportunity to learn the unlimited point of view. And in an unlimited point of view, you can have all points of view, but none of them limit you to a single point of view. And we are limited to a single point of view on this world, which is how linear time drives forward this hologram we work in. The great spikes in the Schumann residence are our ways to detoxify ourselves from linear time, being driving forward the hologram. We can take back our power of this hologram and no longer allow it to be linear focused by an elite class, driving forward the belief system.
Brilliant.
Time is now and the power is in you.
So maybe one last thing I'll ask, Andrew. Like, we're offering this as a reference, and we're on the potentially the other side of it. What might be some symptoms that things like this might be percolating in the reality in us with a no-time sort of oversoul awareness that might be trying to trigger certain senses to be aware of something? Hey, buddy, like in you in linear time, something might be up. Is there some sort of things that might be occurring in individuals in future references of this stuff?
Ringing in the ears, a lot of people will experience that. And it's more than likely your body tuning in to the high frequency of the Schumann resonance or representing your resistance to it. So some of the other common themes, it's going to stir things up. So lots of indigestion issues. People will have indigestion. Food allergies will pop up that you don't normally have. Stress, in the accelerated environment of a high Schumann residence, your cyclical patterns of stress creation, you're going to be creating more stress on your body too. You won't realize it because you're moving, so your energy frequencies are moving so fast, even though your programs are tuned to a such lower amount of energy that, they're not programmed to run on the 110 versus the 3.5.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a bit of a broad comment, but there's just an opportunity to sort of recognize certain themes. So maybe if there's no reference for what you're feeling, it might be related to that. Maybe that might be a good way to.
Everyone's going to be different, and the best way to answer that question is look at your programs and patterns. Be self-observant, self-discerning in yourself. If you see yourself in a cyclical pattern, in that moment, stop and say, "Why am I in my cyclical pattern? What is it my benefit?"
Those
that are unable to go through the healing, they will be run by their programs during high Schumann resonance times. Mm-hmm. Quite literally run. Until such a time the spark of the soul can have enough energy to tell the programs to stop. It's my life. Mm-hmm. Whatever is going on, I'm off duty for the next hour. I'm going outside. I'm going to do whatever the hell I want. Stop engaging the bubble of the hologram and engage the hologram of the self, separate of the rest of the hologram. Mm-hmm. That's what you need to do in these high Schumann resonance times. And those that can't do that on a cyclical basis will be just the hologram will run them, the hologram of everyone else's belief. Which is an attempt of a counter frequency, the Schumann resonance. Why we live in a disunity bubble reality, linked together by linear Roman numeral time. You go to anywhere in the world, all their clocks run on Roman numeral time. You do not see any other indigenous number system that isn't Roman numeral time used anywhere in our modern world.
Very cool, man.
That's the creation of consciousness disresonance, meaning you are no longer resonant to the natural field of the earth, which has its own frequency of time.
Well, I'll round it up there. So thanks, mate. And hope you out there can actually use this as a reference for what might have occurred to you individually in your own path the last couple of weeks, and to potentially go forward, like, sense out that there might be something up, and take on board what we say and maybe revisit this conversation. So thanks, Andrew.
All right. Thanks a lot, Andre. This was fun.
Cheers, mate.